Now, how is this story supposed to start? Let's see. Oh, yes. Once upon a time, there was a princess named Helen, who was lovelier than anyone else in the entire kingdom.
Miss Human.
But wait, that's not really when the story started. It really started long ago, when Helen was just a baby. There was a royal family who had brought peace to their kingdom and led everyone out of the dark ages by inventing a light bulb. Just kidding. They were kind and fair rulers and did what was best for the people. So as a reward for their good deeds, I decided to make their newborn daughter the most beautiful person in the world. But as you will see, making Helen that way was a big mistake.
Contessa, to get love, guess what? I'm never gonna be that girl who's living in a Barbie world. Could wake up and make up and play dumb, pretending that I need a boy who's gonna treat me like a toy. I know the other girlies wanna wear expensive things with diamond rings, but I don't wanna be the puppet that you're playing on the string. This queen don't need a king.
Isn't she the most beautiful thing you have ever seen?
Yeah, man, she's the bit of perfection.
What are you two staring at?
No, we were just...
You were just what? Staring? Gawking? Why don't you go somewhere and mind your own business?
Forgive us, princess.
Like I will.
Can't you behave like a lady?
I must.
Stop acting like such a beast.
Don't call me names, or I'll have you executed like the rest of my teachers.
I meant in a pleasant way, my lady.
Ha! Go away. Sweet, don't you ever just get tired of being sweet?
Sister, you always speak in such trenches. You always make me laugh.
And you always make me sick.
Well, there's this prince. Prince Paris, far, far away. He's coming to our kingdom.
Far, far away? Where the devil is that?
Well, far, far away is a large kingdom east of here. Daddy says the kingdom is larger than ours.
Larger than ours? Then why is that prince coming here? Oh, I know. He's coming to see me, and I spoiled the surprise. How horrible of me.
Well, and
you know what? I must hurry. I want to look my best for our guests. Not that I don't always look my best, but you know.
Actually, he's coming for me.
Poor Kate. Helen has always treated her badly, but Kate Bundy used to be as kind as ever. I must reward her for her goodness. How about a handsome prince? But how can I keep Helen from stealing him? Oh, I know. I'll make him blind. This will surely protect him from Helen's beauty.
Welcome to my kingdom, Prince Paris.
Thank you, my king.
We hope you will enjoy this visit. And this is my lovely daughter, Princess Kate.
Oh, hi, Prince. How are you this lovely day?
Great, Princess. So excited, but great. Tell me something about you.
Well, I have to eat, sleep, and repeat.
Oh, hi, Prince.
Run.
How could you not spot my absolute beauty and stand talking to my poor sister?
Well, Princess, I'm blind. Can't you see? And I thought my sight was only poor.
Well, Helen, he hasn't seen anything.
What do you mean?
He's blind.
Blind? You mean he can't see my beautiful new dress?
I'm sorry.
Well, how do you like my... I mean, how do you like...
The kingdom?
Yes, of course.
It's wonderful. And your sister is going to give me the tour of this kingdom.
You are?
Yeah, your sister has been so kind to me. And I wish I heard this kingdom years ago.
Yes, me too. Well, I'll show her when I'm declared queen of the ball as usual. And then Prince Paris will realize who the best princess is.
Attention, everyone, attention.
We must now crown the queen of the ball. And the winner is Princess Kate.
I can't believe this. They didn't even notice me today. Hey, what did you just do?
I made you invisible. You have been the center of attention for too long.
Aren't you supposed to be nice to me?
I was once. I'm the one who made you beautiful when you were a baby. And now I'm here to correct my error.
Error? There was no error.
There was, Helen. There was. You may be lovely on the outside, but you're ugly on the inside.
How dare you?
You must stay invisible until you learn. Zippity, mippity, whippity, do. You are under a spell, and no one can see you.
And oh my God, what happened to my lovely dress? Who did this to me?
Isn't she crazy? See you later, crazy girl.
Now, what's the trouble in here?
Believe it or not, I'm Princess Helen.
You? The princess? It's just that you look nothing like her. Oh, and what's that filthy stench?
I don't know. I know. My fairy godmother did this to me.
Fairy godmother? I thought fairy godmothers were supposed to be helpful.
Well, I thought the same. Where's that old hag? I'm gonna kill her.
Anyway, I ain't believing you are the princess.
Well, I don't care what you believe. I'll get along fine without you.
Now, don't be like that. In fact, you can stay here as long as you like.
Who is this, Alex?
This is a friend in need.
Helen, my name is Helen, and I'm a princess. Fairy godmother had did it to me.
Oh, don't worry. We'll sort this out. There must be a way to reverse it.
I am the royal scribe. We are offering the reward for the one who knows where Princess Helen is. 100 pieces of gold will be awarded.
100 pieces?
That's a fortune!
So if you see her,
we'll let you know.
Good day.
Wait a minute. How do I know if it's her?
She's the most beautiful lady in the kingdom. You cannot miss her.
But what if something happened? What if she got dirty or messed up somehow? How could you tell it was she?
That's a good question. Let me see. Oh, I remember. She has a birthmark on her foot. You cannot miss her when she takes off her shoes.
Okay, thank you, sir. I'll let you know.
Good day, then.
Let's have lunch, children.
Have a seat, Helen. I don't understand why you're so nice to me. I've never done anything for you.
You're always willing to help those in need, and you look like someone in need.
Thanks, but I've never served before.
Well, this is a good time to start, then.
And why would I want that?
She's our guest, Alex. She didn't need to.
It's now or never, Helen.
But I'm a princess and we don't serve.
You are a spoiled brat.
How dare you?
That's the truth.
Wait, don't fight. We can do it together.
Yeah, I suppose that's a good compromise.
I want Helen to serve me.
I want Helen to serve me too.
Me first.
What do I look like? A servant?
Now look here! You can't go around and yell at my family!
Fine, I'll leave!
Helen, please don't go! Helen, please stay! I'll take care of you!
No matter what I do, you all still like me!
It's because you're beautiful!
But not anymore!
Alex, please let her stay!
Yes, please let her stay!
Fine, I let her stay! Only if she cleans up that bowl she threw down!
Fine, I'll clean it up! You know what? This isn't so bad. It's almost fun.
And clean she did. Helen attacked every piece of dirt like she was dueling an evil. She eventually realized how she was a self-obsessed, mean girl. A few days of her life had changed her forever. She was happy and forever transformed.
I can't believe that you're finally done.
You know what? I haven't had this much fun in my life. But I've never been this tired too.
What's wrong?
My feet, they hurt so badly.
Well, I think you should take your shoes off then.
That sounds good.
You're lying.
Don't stare at it. It's a birthmark and I know it's ugly.
Oh my God! You are the princess?
But I've been trying to tell you that.
Oh, Your Highness, I'm so sorry. I made the princess clean my house.
Oh, Alex, please don't grovel. That's why I liked you. You don't have to treat me this way.
But why?
My stupid fairy godmother did this to me. Correction, my smart fairy godmother. She's made me like cleaning, helping, and being a human. I guess I like not being a princess. I never thought I could live without my beauty. But I guess I can.
Now, should I go get the royal scribe so that you can go home?
And you can get your 100 pieces of gold.
I don't want any reward. I would instead want you to live here.
Oh, Alex, fairy godmother was so right. Inner beauty outweighs external appearances. Thank you for being here.
No, let's thank your fairy godmother.
You girl,
there you are.
Well, this is certainly a change.
I can't thank you enough for what you've done.
Perhaps I overdid a bit. I'll change it back now.
No, wait. I just got used to being this way. I mean, if I go back to being a princess, I can't be with Alex and his family. He and his family were so good to me. He cared for me for who I am, not what I look like. And it felt so good.
Oh, what to do, what to do. Fairy godmother rules say I must change you back since you've learned your lesson.
But what about your family, Helen? They're worried about you.
Oh my God, I forgot about them. How awful of me.
I know, Lola
Princess. Why can't I be with both fairy mother? Both Alex and my family.
I know what to do, Lola Princess.
I understand.
You know, Father, I know I haven't been the nicest person in the world, and my fairy godmother decided to change it.
I'm so glad you're safe.
I don't know what would happen to me if Alex wasn't there.
Alex?
Yes, Your Highness.
Please rise. Hello, children.
Hello, hello. King.
You've all been so wonderful to me. Thank you so much.
Are you leaving us? Helen, please don't go.
She's a princess. She must go.
But I can't just go back to the way I was. I like my new life.
Princess, are you saying you don't want to go home?
I just don't want to be who I was before. I can never be as good as Kate.
What do you mean?
You're always so good, sister. I can never be as good as you.
But you are the most beautiful lady in our kingdom.
I used to think so too. But not anymore. Now I think you've always been the most beautiful person. I just couldn't see it.
Princess, you're going to come home right this instant.
Fairy godmother, do something. I don't want to leave Alex and his wonderful family.
And we don't want to leave our beautiful princess, fairy godmother.
Well, well, people these days don't change for good. But Helen did. I must reward her.